And today I have got to you 6 staffing secrets. If you follow these 6 staffing secrets, there will not be a huge problem. There will not be any problem. My staff ran away. What should I do? This is the most common complaint I get from my restaurateur friends or from people who are trying to run their restaurant and they are not treating their staff properly. Hi, this is Gopal Kamath. I am a hotelier and a restaurateur and the founder of Restaurant Launch Formula, where we teach you all the tips and strategies on how to start and manage a profitable and successful food business of your own. And today I have got to you 6 staffing secrets. If you follow these 6 staffing secrets, there will not be a huge problem. There will not be any problems as far as your staffing is concerned. In fact, if you start following these 6 strategies which I am going to tell you, you will have a waiting list of staff who would want to come and work at your restaurant. Are you interested in getting these 6 strategies? Type yes in the comment section under this video. And let's start with the 6 strategies and 6 secrets about staffing, which will make sure that your staff sticks to your restaurant as glue. So the first one is care for them. This is one of the most common mistakes which I have done. This is the most common mistakes which I have seen so many restaurant owners do, and I believe this is a commonsensical mistake which they do. They don't care about their staff. They don't talk to their staff. They think that their staff is beneath them. They think that the staff, if they talk to them, would take advantage of them. But I believe our employees and our staff are more or less like family owners. Isn't it true, guys and girls, whoever is watching this video, you all? Most of the time we spend more time in our hotel, if you are a restaurant owner, in your hotel, in your restaurant, with your staff, then you spend time with your family. So your staff is your second family and you have to care for them just the way you care for your family. Talk to them, ask them how they are, how are everybody in their house, are they facing any problems. Just even if you talk to them, they will feel a sense of relaxation that the owner is caring about me. They will not feel out of home. They will not feel homesick because they have traveled from thousands of kilometers to come and work for you in your restaurant. So I believe this is the most, at least this is the least which we can do, to talk to them and to care about them, and that will make sure that they feel comfortable in your restaurant, in your business, and stick there and give their best so that you can earn as much profits and you can pay them back in their salaries. The second one is respect them. There is a difference between caring and respecting. A lot of times people talk good to the people talk good with the staff, but then when it comes to work, even if a single mistake is done, they insult the staff in front of the customers and in front of the whole their other colleagues. This is one of the most common mistakes a restaurant owner does. Never ever disrespect your staff, even in front of everybody, nor in front of in front of him. Whenever he has done a mistake, just take him aside, speak to him, and make him understand that, beta, ye aise kar sakte, you could have done it this way. You could have done it this way. Next time, try doing it this way. So, respect and caring go hand in hand. And if a choice is given to a staff who is not respected in a restaurant, and a choice is given to a staff who is respected in a restaurant, but he is still earning a couple of thousands less, the person will choose the other business, the other restaurant where he is getting paid less, because there he has a peace of mind, he is not insulted, he is not treated badly, and the treatment and the emotions which go and the pain which is there is not there. That's why it is very, very important for you to respect the staff at all times. The third one is empowering them. When you are giving your staff a certain activity to do, give them the time and give them the focus to do the activity. Don't go poking your finger, in everything and making sure that, whether he's doing this or no, whether he's doing that or no. When you have given a certain responsibility to him, let him do it. If he does any mistakes, he will come to know, he will rectify it. If you come to know, you can later tell him very, very softly that you should have done it this way, you should have done it that way. Once you start empowering your staff, the staff will develop a skill of his own and he will then excel in whatever department he is handling. So make sure you empower your staff. The fourth is all about paying them on time. A lot of times, the restaurant owners use the money which they want to pay, which they are supposed to pay to the staff, and they are using it for their own funds as a working capital. This is one of the biggest mistakes why you don't get loyal staff, why you don't get a strong loyal team, because you are not loyal to them. If you are not loyal to them as a restaurant owner, how can you expect them to be loyal to you? And that is one of the reasons why a lot of good people leave the restaurants, because they are not getting paid on time. Please remember one thing, that your staff also has a family in his house, at his home, where he has to pay for groceries, he has to pay for the electricity bill, he has to pay for the kids' education, he has to pay for the whatever his requirement for his wife and everything. And he is dependent on you as a owner and the company to take care of these expenses, and he is working in order to earn that salary. So don't deprive him of this. Pay him on time. If possible, pay a couple of days ahead of time. It doesn't matter. It doesn't hurt you to pay a couple of days in advance, but it will make a big difference in his loyalty and a big difference in how he sees your restaurant as a home for himself. So the fifth one is about giving them rest. A lot of times, restaurant owners don't give rest as required to the staff, and the staff then gets tired, and sometimes he falls sick. The reason why he falls sick is because you are not giving periodic rest. You have to give them at least a weekly off, or at least off at a certain period of time, so that he can rest, he can relax, he can sleep, he can get his energy back, and then he can come with full vigor, full vitality, and go and do the activities which are required to make your restaurant successful. And then we come to the last point, help them grow. You should have a step-by-step ascension plan for your restaurant staff, so that, you know, once he starts from a bottom line, he starts and he picks up and he goes on top. So his earnings should also increase, and so should his position be. And that is how you should keep on growing your staff, so that he keeps on growing, he keeps on earning, and there are challenges in front of him. At the same time, he feels a sense of achievement. So these are the six secrets of staffing which you follow. You will never have any problem as far as getting good staff, retaining good team is concerned. And these six secrets are the core of a successful restaurateur, the core of why a restaurant is successful. Any restaurant which you see which is doing very well from ages together is following all these six or any of these secrets.
I hope you guys loved the video, and I'm sure this video and the information is going to help you to open a successful restaurant of your own. Now, if you want to go more deeper and have an in-depth understanding about the restaurant business, I suggest you join my 5 days WhatsApp class. The link is in the description section under this video. And in this 5 days WhatsApp class, I take you step by step through the foundational pillars of restaurant business and the food business. What should be your concept? What should be your location? What should be your thinking like a restaurateur's, like our restaurant owner thinks? And how should you match it with the right type of target clientele? These are the core pillars on which the foundation of your successful restaurant holds. So if you really want to take it to a deeper level and have a better understanding about the restaurant business, go to the link in the description section and sign up for my 5-day WhatsApp class. There is a small fee which I charge, so that you guys are serious and you can take it and implement it to open a successful restaurant of your own. So see you in the 5 days WhatsApp class. Thank you so much for seeing the video up till now, and see you in my next video. Thank you so much. This is Gopal Kamath signing off. Bye-bye. Love from me. Bye.